Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Nordic Turns. Alan is from Halmstad, Sweden. How are you all? I hope you all are good. I will discuss a little bit about English requirement now, and then after that I will talk about three questions answer. I think the questions is really important, and I need to answer them very quickly. I don't have free time nowadays because I'm very busy with my work and some official traveling. So I cannot do so many videos like earlier, but I will try to give some videos about my question and answer from the episode 8 to 13. I already shoot the videos, but I don't have time to make the the editing and put some text on there and preparing the videos in the software. It takes a lot of time to make them download and then post it, upload it in a YouTube channel. So I couldn't make the time for that, but you will receive soon the question and answer episode, I think so. So first of all, the English requirement has been changed, that you know all. From this year, they will not allow medium of instruction English for the bachelor degree if you are from the country of Bangladesh. So if you are from Bangladesh, if your medium of instruction in your bachelor degree is English, you cannot apply in English Shopping University. But other some universities also have taken the decision, but this decision is from which year they didn't mention. So the main point of this, actually I would recommend you that which university you apply, you check your account and then the mail options, because there are lots of mail will coming if your university has been decided that they will not take this kind of medium of instruction English. So you will get the mail from the university soon, and if you already applied like Gothenburg University, Lund University, Linköping University, they will notify you in your account. So check your account. If they notify you that your medium of instruction English will not be okay for your English requirement, then you have to upload your IELTS or TOEFL exam English requirement, because Linköping University already decided that they will not take any student from Bangladesh who has a medium of instruction English for their bachelor degree. But for other university, they didn't decide yet. They just announced that they will also follow that rules, but which year they didn't mention. So it's a little bit tricky. This year, maybe not this year, maybe next year, but Linköping University will not allow this year. So you have to be very sure about that. But don't be rushed, don't be insane on that, because it's a university decision. And why they take this decision? This is their internal problem. This is their internal requirement that we cannot do anything on that. But I would recommend you that if you don't, if you apply in Gothenburg or some other universities, but you didn't get any mail that you need to upload an IELTS or TOEFL exam paper, Shopping University, you will get the mail, or you would. But from other university, if you don't get, you don't need to upload any kind of IELTS or any kind of TOEFL or other English requirement papers to upload, because very short to upload the documents and send the documents, because 1st of February is the last date to arrive the all the documents in or upload the documents in the website and the, to their address to send to, and difficult to take the decision that for the Linköping University you will do now the IELTS exam, and it takes long time to take the preparation, like minimum 2 months. So you cannot do like this. You will sit the exam and then you will get 6.5. It's a little bit difficult, but if you study, then you can. It depends on your merit. If you are a talent, you are brilliant, then it's nothing to be worried about, because 1 month is the minimum preparation. I did my IELTS exam in 1 week, and then I get 7.5, not less than 7 in any band score. So I would recommend you that you take minimum 1 to 2 months of preparation for the IELTS exam, or not to apply in Linköping University. Other university is still they are open with the medium of instruction English, but they just take the decision that they will not allow from Bangladesh medium of instruction English, but from which year they didn't mention. So I will recommend you to check your account mail, and you will get mail or notification if they change their mind. So I think you already know how to handle that. Now I will go to Tayabuddin, who write that those who already apply already to the university, specific university, select their subject, what they will do. Just follow the instruction that I give now, that you, if you applied already in Linköping University with the medium of instruction English, that will not work. You have to upload English requirement like IELTS or TOEFL, otherwise they will not allow any student from Bangladesh with a medium of instruction English from the bachelor degree. But other university, they didn't decide yet from which year they will take the decision. So you can, you should not do anything about that, like other university except Linköping. So if you are like from the Gothenburg, from Malmo University or from Stockholm University, if they change their mind, they will mail you. They will notify you. For Linköping University, they extend their time. It will be 20th of February. You can upload your IELTS documents until 20th of February this year. So usually this is 1st of February, but for this kind of uncertain sudden request requirement, they extend their time limit for the documents. So you can have some like 20th February, so you have more than 1 month time to take the preparation and to have the IELTS exam for the score. So I think you are really understand my point, what I'm talking about, and you will do accordingly, right? Okay. Then I will go to one important question. Writing here, Tazmina Tarannum. Hello, bhaiya. I was always watching videos. Thank you very much. I have a question that is Sanchoy Potro is counted as financial proof. I have a black bank Sanchoy Potro. Please reply. Dear sister, Tarannum, the Sanchoy Potro, like the savings account deposit, it's not cash or liquid money to show for a bank statement. You have to show liquid money that is deposit in the bank in your current account. So you can, you have the money you will show for your bank account, this will be for your expense when you will be in Sweden. So you cannot show something like that. You are prohibited to show Sanchoy Potro or deposit money. So you have to cash it, take it in your account, current account, and then you can show this. Otherwise, Sanchoy Potro or deposit account money will not be allowed to show for the bank statement. I think you are clear now. Thank you. Laboni Ishra Juthi, that student, I passed my HSC exam 2014, and then I have a problem with my study. I want to do my diploma or bachelor program if it is possible for any girl. I will not recommend you to do the bachelor degree in Sweden, because Sweden is not well or good country for the bachelor program. There are lots of countries, Austria, Germany and Norway, who doesn't have any tuition fee for that. So I would recommend you to do the more study on Norway, Germany or some other countries allow without tuition fee. So you can do your bachelor degree and then you can come to Sweden for your master's program. I would recommend, there is no gender discrimination here. If you are a girl, if you are a lady, there is no problem at all to live in the northern countries or northern European countries. So I would recommend you to take the preparation accordingly. So now Asif Mahmud from Dhaka, he is asking an important question, that after HSC, if he is studying in pharmacy to any private university or public university, is there any chance to come here after the bachelor degree for the master's program in Sweden with the pharmacy? There are lots of study courses and programs with the pharmacy subject. So I would recommend you, you can apply lots of subject in Sweden, all over the Sweden, in Uppsala University, in Lund University, in KTH Royal University. We have one subject here as well in Halmstad University, from the background from pharmacy. I had a friend from pharmacy, from Nordic Turns University, also a junior brother from Nordic Turns University, from pharmacy department, who are already studying in Halmstad University, lost 1 year, and now they are about to complete their study. So for the master's program, pharmacy is a very good subject, and you can choose lots of variety subject if you are from the background of pharmacy. So I would recommend you can study pharmacy in a private or public university. Don't worry about that, just be study very well and do a very good score so that you can get a chance, and also take the preparation for the IELTS or TOEFL exam so that you will be admitted like the tick. You will select it for the visa and other obstacle that those are sensitive for other students who are struggling with. So I wish you best of luck. Thank you, Asif. I would recommend that everyone has a nice preparation because there are no time. Today is 10th of January and 15th of January is the last time for the application to the universityadmissions.se for master's program 2019 autumn semester in Sweden. So I would recommend everyone to be serious on the application process and choose the university and the location, because the location is related with the job. If you are in the rural location, you will not get any good job. If you are in an urban or in the capital city, nearby the capital city, you will get a good job. I think so, but it depends on your luck. It depends on your industry. If you are industrious, if you are more lucky, then maybe you will get a good job. I wish you best of luck, everyone. Assalamualaikum. Allah Hafiz.